Hi everybody, I'm Mattia, this is the Despina team, and we are very happy to be here and present the Energy Saver app. So let me introduce the team. I'm Mattia, with me there is Blagoj.
Hi, I'm Goran.
Hi, I'm Sylvan.
Piero.
Okay, so what is the idea?
Okay. Thank you all. It was an amazing journey today. Okay, we really appreciate the conference. Only one introducing words. Okay, I'm not a developer. We speak about pro code, low code, so on. I'm a CEO. So basically, I don't code anymore. It's been 20 years, yesterday for me was an occasion to understand better what is the capability of this platform. Okay, the guys were really amazing, and when the game get tough, I went to dinner, so I didn't conclude, okay? They conclude for me, so I'm here to take the advantage, as all the bosses do with everyone, particularly the developers, okay? So, basically, the key idea is to, let's say, save energy, okay? How can we do this? Okay, by intelligent light and bulb, but basically, Alexa, we got plenty of devices that do this, okay? Our idea was to adjust the brightness automatically and do some reporting according to the geolocalization of the bulb. Okay, so to allow, for example, here I was impressed that with the day, the northern light, okay, there's no need to be, for the bulb to be up until 8, 9, 10 o'clock. Okay, so the thing was to control remotely the bulb in the office, to receive notification in case someone forgot to turn off the light, okay, receive warning messages in case of inefficiency, and the capability to adjust the brightness. Okay, I stop myself because I let the guys explain you better because I don't understand exactly what they have done, but I can assure you it works, okay? So this is the main thing. Okay.
So what we actually did here, we mainly used the Neptune Open Edition. We make the solution divided in two main units. The one was the server controlling, and the second one was the application. What we used from the Neptune Open Edition technologies, it was the Neptune database. Then we used the server scripting. We also used the front end for building the application. We used SubUI 5. And of course, the API of the bulb itself. So here we controlled the effects, saturations, and further settings. Here we used a prepared building block, so everything was fast and ready to use. Of course, the application, when we started to thinking, we make the sketching, the prototype in the new Neptune application builder. Once we concluded that this is a good idea, we just move to the application designer that is well known, and then we just continue to develop the application. Mainly, that was the solution of the application.
Okay, so this is the application. We recognize all the devices that are in a different place. So we can select the place. For example, Norway, Oslo. And here we see that there is one device.
Okay, here I would like to add, because due to some technical issues, we cannot really demonstrate what we did. Basically, the scenario was we were using only one light, one bulb. It is a small scenario where we tried to prove that the light is connected to the network. Then we use the device ID. Based on the device ID, we have a configuration in our database, and then we have the automatic location detection. So we run a server script that checks the geolocation and compares the actual location with the location of the bulb setup. It means that every device that is nearby you will appear in this list, so we'll get a control through the application. And the second part that I initially mentioned is the server controller. Our idea was to have automatic control, so by API of the geolocation, you detect where you're located. If it is, for example, night, it will turn on the lights. It is the automatic proposal, and of course, you can make your own human control by the application. When it the day it's coming, the light is going down, and it's saving energy, because all we know, we are humans, and we usually forget to do switch on, switch off. Switch on we do, but switch off, no, usually forget.
So. Thank you. I'm sorry for not having more time for you guys, but this is like running. Also, the fact that this solution is not only for lights, that actually could be applied to anything that can be IoT. Heating, on the floor, on the wall, AC, anything that can be have sensors into it, you can actually do this. And they did this in a serverless way, meaning that there was nothing in between Neptune and the devices. So directly connecting and controlling. So. Very easy to set up kind of home IoT if you want to as well. Our next guests, welcome on stage.
Hello everybody, so nice to be here. Yeah, we had a great time yesterday on the hackathon. Our idea is this sort of the future of travel expenses. And this is the team. We have Ivan, Louis here, Cesar, Deepa, and Tarjei, and me, Tarjei. And actually, this is my first time with Neptune Impact yesterday, or Neptune. And yeah, it was very fun. So our idea is basically, because these guys work at this Norwegian service center for public companies and governmental departments, and they handle, amongst other things, over 1 million travels every year. So our app has focus on like encouraging workers to make more environmental sustainable choices when they're out traveling, and first and foremost, it's like a new solutions for filling out travel expenses. So we imagine, like, in the future, this is very, you know, thinking about the triple bottom line and stuff like that. In addition to filing your expenses, you will also have to fill out your environmental cost when you're out traveling, you know. So here we have this mobile app where you can scan receipts. Like these, we imagine these QR codes are like the receipts in the future, and they will probably contain more data than today. So they will probably contain like CO2 emissions and maybe kilometers. And so here you can see like your trip shows up in this system, and you can see where you traveled and how many CO2 and kilometers your trip has cost. So this is like for the employees to fill out their travel expenses. We want them to make like a smooth experience, like not have another thing that you have to do, but this is just like on top or instead of your current travel experience. And then we also made a management view. So as a manager or a boss where you have to manage employees, and also for the employees themselves, they can see diagrams on how well each department is doing in regards to emissions. And so here you can see how much CO2 each department is doing, and maybe inspire healthy competition between employees and stuff. So they, when they're out traveling, maybe they will choose to take electric taxis or maybe even ride bicycles around, so they don't get so many emissions. And also another thing is like missed flights. Mm-hmm. It's very expensive for the environment. So this also tracks, or imagines we will track that. So think that's about it.
What we can mention.
One of the things that we really found interesting about this use case is because it's something that it's asked by customers to be implemented, right? And this is something that will help people avoid unnecessary travel that will return into less CO2 being emitted. At the same time, if you're conscious of how much you are emitting, you probably will be less driven to actually do so. So overall, the classical take a picture of your receipt and it just goes as a dumb picture is changed by the fact that you can add this kind of unwritten metadata to it that will create all of this kind of consciousness about sustainability and CO2. So
yeah, so true.
Thank you. Our next guests were the winners. And the use case that they're going to present is unique, different from the ones we've seen until now. All three of them are different, but they do have a very interesting angle. I think this is probably all the other applications are, could be potentially a B2B or B2E. This is an idea of an application driven by community. So please welcome on stage the winners of the Neptune Hackathon 2022.
All right, hi everyone. The topic of the yesterday's hackathon was sustainability. And because we don't know anything about building windmills or wind turbines, we know something about software and how the software can support business, we thought that we will just approach this topic a bit differently. And but before we start, let's meet our team. We're called Team Galatea. Galatea is one of the moons of Neptune. So please meet Daniel, Dennis, Yuris, and Andreas. Andreas, please explain us a bit about the problem that we've tried to resolve.
Yes, I will. Hello. Most probably you have been to Oslo and you have been experiencing the wonderful countryside, especially the seaside of Oslo. And who of you have been to the parks in Oslo? Just raise your hand. Anyone? They are great. They're wonderful. But they are experiencing a huge threat. And this threat comes from the normal threat as a city tree, from heat, from pollution, from small space in the soil. But nowadays, unfortunately, from climate change. It's not only the temperature that matters, but it's especially the dry time which brings the stress to the trees, and they are dying. Take a look at Würzburg, for example. It's a mid-sized town in Germany. We have about 140,000 inhabitants, and a couple of 10,000 city trees. And each year, there is dying about 1,000 trees in the city, which is really bad. And most of you have experienced one of the most wonderful moments in the parks among trees and have a connection to it. And the point is, how can we save the city trees? So, how can we save the city trees? Because the city trees actually saves us from heat and from dying at the end. And the idea is that we use community engagement so that every person can adopt a city tree or can find his city tree, which is in the street in front of his house, and care for it. And how it's done will be presented now.
Okay, thank you. So we thought about actually supporting the community or urban green offices by engaging community to help in looking after the trees. So one of the apps that we created is an inventory for trees. So it's a registry where we have information about each tree that has some strategical importance for the city. And we created also an app for end user for the community, so they can go around in their neighborhood, they find a tree, they can report that something is wrong happening with the tree, and they can send a picture of a leaf if something is not okay with that, and they can also look after, you know, what's going on with the tree that they has, let's say, adopted. And another component that we came up with is an AI component that recognizes the leaves. Based on the leaves, we are able to say whether the leaf represents a sickness of a tree or is a healthy one. So let's see this in a demo. Yeah, so I will just refresh. All right. So in the map, we have a list of trees that actually they are coming from the database of Würzburg from Germany. So they are placed on the map. But let's focus on the Oslo area. We have a few trees that are in our inventory database. We can select one. And as you can see, each of the trees has a QR code. That QR code identifies the tree, so someone from the community can come to the tree. The tree could have a label with the printed QR code. Go in, click report the problem, scan the QR code, report that the leaf is, let's say, gray, and take a picture of it. I have some pictures in here. Yeah, and submit the information about the tree. In this way, the urban green offices knows that that something is wrong with that tree, because the information about the leaf, whether this is okay or healthy or sick, is updating the status of the tree. So I just wanted to show you the this is should be a list of the trees and the pictures that I have reported. Of course, the demo gods are not with us today. Okay, maybe not today. But I wanted to quickly show you that the AI, how it works. So we have two pictures of the leaf. One is sick, one is healthy, at least on the visual. If I select this one, the AI tells us that this tree is sick. And if I take if I take the other one, yeah, it's healthy. Yeah, so thank you very much.
The cool thing of all of this is not just a brilliant idea. It has actually a real-life database and use case behind it that can be community-driven, then using the power of machine learning and AI to actually simplify the way for services to be signaled, say, something is wrong with this tree or not. So therefore, reducing the manual or human effort of identifying that. Obviously, not picture-perfect, but works. Yeah. Thank you, and I would like to welcome everyone from the hackathon on stage for a big applause. Thank you for participating, thank you for the effort, and thank you to everyone else that is probably in the audience that also participated. thank you. It was really inspiring to see what you guys have created in 8 hours with a tooling that you haven't seen before, most of you. So that was amazing. Thank you so much.